I'm back over here again on my list here. I'm going down my list, and as I see here, I've talked about the shortcuts, I've talked about the user manual, I've talked about this, the data. I want to talk about preferences, but today isn't preferences. I have my list, and I have a happy face because we need to be happy. Happy is good. Okay, so let's continue on. All right, enough of my nonsense and silliness here. I'm such a silly, silly character. I'm going to come in here into the Extras tab, and I'm going to click on Preferences. In the Preferences window, we're going to go through some of the little features that I feel are nice to have, especially when you're first setting up your unit. You want to set in your time and date and your scaling and how you're going to move everything around. So let's start off here in the general category. In the general category here, okay, we can check our language. So we have here English, Spanish, Arabic, French, Italian, Chinese, Polish, Russian, Turkish. Oh, wait, that wasn't. One of these is Chinese and one of these is. This is Chinese, I think. And then this is another Asian language that I'm not completely familiar with because I can't read it. I need to go back to school. I can't read it. Okay. So as we're looking at this, you can choose your language of choice. Okay. Your measurement system. Do you wish to be in the metric system or in the imperial system? There are certain places in the world where they think in feet and inches, and there are other places in the world we think in meters, centimeters, millimeters, kilometers, etc. meters. So wherever you are, you can set it to your preference. Now, we can do our transformation parameters. I keep it at the default, 1:1, scale by 1.25. If you wanted to change it because you feel that you want to scale faster, you can increase the speed of which it scales by. Good example here. If you keep it there, you will see you change your preferences. And I just one notch, it'll do it 6 times as I set it. Or I come back here, come back into my preferences on the scaling, and go back to the normal. Now when I scale, it'll scale down a little bit slower. Depending how you want it is what you can set it at. So, moving on. Oh, I just realized I have a bad habit now. I'm using the word so way too often. I'll have to quit that. Your time is AM or PM. And then your GPS coordinates are, let me think, there's the WAS measurement, and then this is the digital measurement. All depending how you like to have it is the way that you can carry it in there. So moving on, missing characteristics notification, automatically scale, crosshair overflow, which means that if you're moving your crosshairs, it'll continue to go round and around. Raw scan value, nice function to have if you're in the professional software. I can recommend it. You can see the raw scale value that was given into that particular point on the measurement, on the scan. And then you can see that. That's why it's clicked here. Advanced scan information. I like to have it. Don't really need it. Online updates. Absolutely. If there's a new update, if there's an improvement to the software, grab it. The software is extremely stable. It has been one of the most stable softwares I've used over the years. It works. If there is a new update, that means a bug was found and it will correct it. Or there is a new feature. And by using that, you will get the feature. Keep that available. Check it, please. Online update when available. Okay. So then you have your volumetric resolution. Keep it at medium. Continuing on, then we have our folders. Where do we want to store our information? And this is just really one of those, go through the line. You can just store it like any other normal file, or you can set your presets here. Simple done, not a lot of work. In order to change a preset, you click on the folder here, and it's going to open up your Windows tab. You can take a look at your Windows tab. Where do I want to save it, etc. And that's how you go. If I want to save it on my desktop, I put it here. I click on desktop. If I want to put it into the marketing department, I put it in there. If I want to put it in my detectors or my Instagram, or regardless of where you want to put it, that's your choice. It's just a quick little function. Here are some quick little shortcuts if you wanted to use those. Okay. This covers our segment now on preferences, and we're going to continue on with our next subject. Please stay along for the entire video series. A lot of good information coming. Thank you.